让我们凭着神的应许来到他的面前，把我们的重担忧愁卸给他。
In accordance to God's promise that we could shed away our labors and come to Him and to be receiving peace.
让今天成为我们一个礼拜最享受的一天。
So let today be the day that we enjoy.
就是享受神。
That we can enjoy God.
我们一起来祷告，求主带领我们早上的聚会。
Let us pray and ask God for His guidance throughout today's service.
我们一起来祈祷。
Let us pray.
愿大家平安。
Peace be among everyone.
今天早上跟大家一起来学习两难之间。
This morning I'd like to learn with everyone with the topic Heart Pressed Between the Two.
我们看腓立比书的第一章。
Let's turn to Philippians chapter 1.
腓立比书第一章的二十二节。
Philippians,
二十三节。
Philippians chapter 1 verse 23.
请读。
Philippians chapter 1 verse 23. For I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better.
这里保罗说，我正在两难之间。
Here Paul says, I am hard pressed between the two.
那这两难是什么？
What are the two factors that he's pressed against?
因为他被关到监牢里面。
Because he was imprisoned.
随时都有殉道的可能。
He had the chance to be sacrificed of his life.
所以死亡对他来讲是很实在的一件事情。
So to him, death is really it could happen to him anytime.
所以他的两难就是到底我活着好还是死好。
So in this case, the context for him is he's hard pressed between whether to die or to live.
因此保罗面对人生的最后一个时刻，他在描写他对生死的看法。
So these few verses in Philippians talks about Paul's perspective about life and death.
因为我们对死亡的看法会影响我们怎么活在这个地上。
And how we view death has a lot to do and influence to how we live.
那常常我们因为每一天很自然的，特别是生活很顺利，一天过一天，很少去想到死这一件事情。
Oftentimes, we go about our business, live our daily lives, and very rarely we think about the notion of death.
那因为对死这件事情没有认真的去思想，所以我们对活也没有很认真的去想到底要怎么活。
So therefore, because we have not spent time to think about death, nor have we spent a lot of time think about how we should live.
所以如果对死亡有一个很清楚的认识，我们的生活方向就会很正确。
So likewise, if we have a very clear understanding about death, then we will have a very clear direction in terms of how we should live.
最近跟两个神学生一起在学习圣经的道理。
Recently, I've been studying the Bible with two theological students.
我很好奇问他们，你现在几岁啊？
I asked them, how old are you?
还不到四十岁。
Both of them are not even 40 years old.
他们本来都有很好的职业。
Previously, they both have great careers.
有很幸福的家庭。
They all have wonderful families.
这个是算人生的一个巅峰时间。
And really, they were at the pinnacle of their lives.
但是在还不到40岁，会想要改变人生的跑道，这是不简单。
So to me, for them to offer their lives to Christ, to commit to Christ at not even 40 years old, that was very impressive to me.
因为这不只是会影响他们，也会影响他们的家庭。
Because that decision not only impacts them, but also impacts their family members.
更会影响教会。
Also, it will influence and impact church.
所以我们每一个人生活方向的改变会带给教会很大的影响。
So likewise, the directions we take in our daily living will influence our church.
我记得去看过一个姐妹。
I once visited a sister.
她生病很严重。
She was ill.
她在大概是只有四十几岁。
She was about 40 years old.
啊，她说，如果主耶稣再一次让我好起来，我一定要从心里实实在在的爱神跟爱人。
She tells me that if the Lord Jesus Christ would heal her and let her live again, she would devote her thoughts and mind to Christ.
啊，她真的了解人为什么活着。
Because she came to the realization why a person, the meaning of life is.
啊，但是第三天她离世了。
But unfortunately, 3 days after that, she passed.
因为她的时候到了。
Because her time has come.
啊，另外一个弟兄啊，在80年代啊，事业做得非常顺利。
There once was a brother in the 1980s. He had a very successful career.
啊，那个时候他常常对啊。朋友说啊，他要到非洲去打猎。
He often boasted to his friends that he would like to go to Africa to hunt.
啊，后来生了一场很严重的病。
But all of a sudden he became ill.
他真的觉悟人为什么活着。
He came to the realization the true meaning and purpose of life.
哦，他说，如果神让我好起来，我要到非洲去传道。
He lamented that if God heals his illness, that he will go to Africa to preach instead.
但是第二个月他就离世了。
Unfortunately, 2 months after he said that, he passed away.
所以我们从保罗在两难之间，让我们来想想跟生跟死这一件事情。
So through what Paul has stated in his reference to being hard pressed between the two, let us contemplate aboutthe meanings of our life and the meaning of our deaths.
好，回来看第一章二十三节。
Let's turn to Philippians chapter 1, verse 23.
中间说，我情愿离开世界与基督同在，这是好的无比的。
Paul says here, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better.
当然生死在神的控制啊。
Ultimately, we realize that whether we live or die, that's up to God.
但是保罗说，如果我能够选择，我要选择死，因为这是好的无比的。
However, Paul here says that if he had the choice, he would choose to depart from this world because that is far better.
每一个人都想要活下去。
I'm sure every one of us has the desire to live.
如果有一个人他选择死，常常是因为活下去很痛苦。
For a person to choose death over life, perhaps for that person, living is far more painful.
所以他觉得死比活好。
That's why that person would decide that death would be better than living.
最近有一个姐妹在见证。
Recently, there was a testimony from one of our sisters.
她的母亲活的年纪很大。
She had a mother that was very advanced in age.
在最后一段时间活得很辛苦。
But during the latter part of her mother's life, she had a very difficult life.
大概是半昏迷的状态。
She was unconscious for a long time.
有一天她就向神祷告。
One day, the sister prayed to God.
若神啊，如果你愿意啊，求你让她好起来。
She prays to God that, Lord, if you are willing, please let my mother regain her health.
但是如果你要接她回去，请你赶快接她回去，因为她真的活得很辛苦。
But if your decision is to take her life, please take her swiftly because she is suffering.
那在很认真祷告，她感觉到圣灵告诉她。
In her prayer and concentration, she felt that the Holy Spirit was telling her.
说你要去告诉你的妈妈。
The Holy Spirit was telling her, you should go talk to your mother.
要把心理上她跟人的过节要解开。
To tell your mother to unlock some of the misunderstandings and entanglements that you have with others in this world.
其实她的母亲很热心啊。
In actuality, her mother has a really good faith, very zealous in church.
有时候到教会来聚会。
She often comes to service.
最后一段时间常常坐轮椅。
And toward her latter parts of her days, she was in a wheelchair.
那要祷告，她用爬的爬到前面来。
She would crawl to the front of the chapel to pray.
真的很热心。
She was very zealous and
fervent. 但是很热心她心里还是有一个结，就是别人对她的结，她解不开。
However, despite of her zeal and faith towards God, she still had a knot in her heart against others.
所以她就去见她的母亲。
So therefore, she, the sister, proceeded to talk to her mother.
奉主耶稣的圣名啊，对她母亲讲，你要把这个解过去。
She spoke to her in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and told her that you need to untie this knot in your heart.
啊，然后帮她祷告。
And then she proceeded to pray with her mother.
那过了不多久，她母亲就断气了。
And after not long after that, her mother passed.
哦，所以一个人想要死，常常是因为活得很痛苦。
Therefore, sometimes a person in this world would like to choose death over life because living is more painful for that person.
但是保罗这里讲啊，离开世界，这是好的无比的。
However, Paul here says that his desire to depart from this world is actually a better choice.
为什么？
Why?
因为穿过死的这一道门，要进入另外一个世界。
Because he knows that after he goes through, walks through the door, the gate of death, that he will enter upon a new realm.
这个叫做乐园。
And that realm is the heavenly kingdom.
所以生跟死差多久？差不到一秒钟。
To him, life or death is just a second apart.
因此从这个物质的地面进到属灵的乐园，差不到一秒钟。
It only takes a second for a person to depart from this spiritual material world and enter into the spiritual realm.
好，那保罗他面对死亡，他往前看，他看到什么？
So as Paul sets forth his perspective towards death, what does he see?
有公义的冠冕为我存留。
He sees that the crown of righteousness is awaiting him.
有他所爱的神，爱他的神在等待他。
He sees the God that he beloves is awaiting for him.
哦，所以这是好的无比的。
So to him, that was more desirable than anything.
哦，所以他觉得啊，能够离开世界，这是好的无比的。
So to him, that's why he desired to depart from this world, and he equated that to better than anything.
哦，但是啊，如果我们回到二十三节
，But if we go back to verse 23, 24. Nevertheless, to remain in the flesh is more needful for you.
好，这个二十四节讲啊，我肉身活着为你们更是要紧。
Here says that Paul acknowledges that for him to remain in his flesh is more needful for the folks at that time.
为什么？
Why?
我们看二十五节。
Let's turn to verse 25. Verse 25, and being confident of this, I know that I shall remain and continue with you all for your progress and joy of faith.
因为如果我活着，能够与你们众人同住，来让你们的信仰道上又长进又喜乐。
Paul acknowledges that if he stays living, he knows that he will remain and continue to continue with their progress and joy of faith.
也就是保罗觉得，如果他活下去，对其他的信徒，对教会的圣工会大有帮助。
In other words, Paul understands that if he lives, then he will have great benefits to the work and faith of the members at the time.
所以虽然在监牢里面很危险，随时都有可能死亡，他就知道他不会死。
Therefore, even though he was imprisoned, he realized that he faces death upon any moment. He was not fearful because
因为神还有工作叫他做。
Because he realized that God still has work for him.
所以圣经里面对生死的看法跟我们一般人的了解不一样。
So if you pay attention, the notion of life and death in the Bible is very different from normal people's notions.
比方说，如果一个人有癌症
，For example, if a person has cancer,
我们一般人都是鼓励他要乐观。
Most of us would encourage that person to be optimistic.
比方说，如果你癌症第一期，可能你有90%的存活率。
If you are in the early stages of cancer, you have a very high percent of success survival rate.
Yeah. 那你为什么注意一直在看那个百分之十，看百分之九十？
If your survival rate is 90%, why would you be negative and only focus on the 10% possibility that you might die?
如果是第二期，你有70%的存活率。
If you're in a stage 2 of cancer, you may have 70% of survival rate.
所以要乐观啊，你要看那个70，为什么一直看30%？
So we might encourage that person, you need to be positive and optimistic. Focus on the 70% of survival rate as opposed to
所以一个人生很严重的病，我们叫人要乐观，常常是用统计数字来告诉他你要乐观。
So, when we confide and counsel others having cancer, we might ask them to be optimistic because of the statistics that we're aware of.
但是当我们回到圣经里面，看法就不一样。
However, if we look at the Bible, its concept and notion of life and death is different.
如果神还有工作要我们做，
if God has tasks for us to carry out,
再大的车祸不会死。
No matter what kind of ailment or accident, you will not die.
再严重的疾病也不会死。
No matter what sort of illness you contract, you will not die.
因为神掌握生死。
Because God controls life or death.
那神还有工作叫我们做，就不会死。
And if God has the desire for us to live, to carry out his work, then we shall not pass.
那保罗本身就是一个例子。
So Paul is a classic example of this notion.
他曾经被石头打到别人以为死了，把他拖到城外去走了。
He once was stoned to almost to the point of death, where he was dragged along the roadside.
结果他醒过来到另外一个城去传福音。
When he woke up, he walked to the next adjacent city to preach.
在往罗马的路程，在船坏了好几次，他觉得自己活命的指望都没有了。
He was capsized on his path to Rome. He thought he would have faced death multiple times.
但是神安慰他。
But God comforted him.
你要到罗马为神做见证。
Confirmed that his task was to go to Rome to testify for the Lord.
所以每一次遇到危险他都不会死。
So every time it seemed like when he encountered danger, he prevailed.
因为神的工作还没有做完。
Simply because his task commissioned by the Lord is still with him.
我们如果看约拿也是这样。
If you look at Jonah, he was another example.
约拿要逃避神。
Jonah was trying to escape from God.
这个人的个性很强。
He was very stubborn.
所以在船上起风暴。
Even when he was on the boat, when he encountered the storm.
那就抽签就抽到约拿。
The lot was cast to Jonah.
大家问约拿，那你做了什么事情得罪神呢？
So the people asked Jonah, what have you done to offend the Lord?
约拿没有悔改啊，他说你把我丢下去，风浪就平静了。
Jonah did not repent, rather he said, why don't you throw me off the boat and the storm will calm.
所以他以为丢下去死了就死了，结束了。
He thought to himself, why don't he just end his life and just do away with everything.
真的丢下去风浪平静了。
And indeed, when they cast him off the boat, the storm calmed.
但是约拿没有死啊。
But Jonah did not die.
神安排一条鱼把他吞下去。
God was caused him to be swallowed by a whale.
他在鱼肚子里面三天三夜。
He was in the whale's stomach for 3 days and 3 nights.
没有死，这是神迹啊。
That was a miracle.
为什么？因为神有工作要叫他做。
And he did not die. And why? Because God had task for him.
所以在鱼肚子里三天之内很痛苦，他才真的悔改。
It was during the 3 days and night where he was suffering in the fish's stomach where he truly felt that he needed to repent.
那他一悔改啊，神就吩咐那鱼把他吐出去，刚好在尼尼微旁边。
The minute that he repented, God ordered the fish to spit out Jonah, and coincidentally, that was at Nineveh.
所以圣经里面很多的例子都告诉我们，神有工作要我们做，不会死。
So there's a lot of examples in the Bible that indicates that when God has something for us to carry out, we will not lose our lives.
如果我们看约伯,
if we look at Job.
啊，约伯生病是何等的严重啊！
He was ill, and he contracted a grave disease.
哦，所以他的朋友啊，三天三夜讲不出话来。
So his friends, upon seeing Job, was not able to even speak to him for many days.
约伯咒诅自己的生日。
Job condemned his own birthday.
但是他不会死啊。
And yet he did not die.
因为神要借着他在患难中啊，能够坚守他的信仰，这样来荣耀神。
Because God still had task for him to be able to prevail through his calamities and to keep his faith.
所以他的太太信到最后说：“啊，你弃掉神算了吧，死掉算了吧，你拜神拜到这样还有什么用？”
Even his wife toward the end told him, "Why don't you just forsake your faith towards God? Why don't you just die?"
哦，但是约伯说神是应该称颂的。
However, at the end, Job still acknowledged that he still has to praise the Lord.
神本身的存在就是很伟大。
He acknowledged that the mere existence of God is great.
所以他持守信仰的纯正。
Therefore, that allowed him to sustain his faith.
啊，因此在这里保罗告诉我们。
So over here, Paul is telling us this.
啊。我们面对生死啊，不要怕。
That we shall not be fearful when we encounter life or death.
要有信心。
We have to have confidence.
如果神还有事情叫我做，我不会死。
That if God still has a will for us to continue to carry out His task, then nothing will happen to us.
但是如果我工作做完呢
？However, if our tasks are completed.
如果我工作做完，死是好的无比的。
If our tasks are completed, then death will be better than anything.
所以我们每一个人站在生命的最后一点，有两个方向可以看。
So every one of us, as we are staring down upon the end of our lives, we have two possible paths.
第一个回头看。
The first approach is to look behind.
第二个往前看。
Second approach is to look ahead.
当我们回头看的时候
，When we look behind,
我们常常发现每一个人的生活都一样。
We realize that, in compared to everyone else, everybody's lives are the same.
所以人一生啊，日光之下没有新事。
That's why, in the Bible says that under the sun there's nothing new.
人怎么活，为什么活，大概都一样。
How people live and why do people live?Have great parities.
第一个就是求学。
Many people live to pursue after knowledge or school.
要受更好的教育。要受更好的教育。
To receive better education.
目的为着找到好的工作。
With the goal of able to find a good job.
有好的工作就有好的收入。
Having a good job means good salary.
目的。有更舒服的生活。
With the goal of striving a comfortable life.
再建立一个幸福的家庭。
And then to establish a very blissful family.
然后享受人生应该享的福分。
And then to enjoy the blessings and bounties of this world.
这样一直忙下去。
And so on and so forth, that continues our lives.
忙到退休，把握机会，环游世界。
We toil, We take advantage of our opportunities in this world until retirement.
每一个人的生活大同小异，差不了多少。
Every one of people in this world, their lives are similar in this fashion.
所以每一个人站在生命最后一点回头看，大部分都一样。
Therefore, every one of us, as we're standing facing death, looking back, we will see similar things.
但是如果我们只是为着这样活着
，However, if that's the only reason that we live，
当我们往前看，看到什么
？And if that's the case, if we look forward, what do we see？
我们看到的就是所罗门看到的。
We will see what King Solomon saw.
就是虚空啊。
Vanity.
为什么是虚空
？Why vanity？
这个就好像一个人很认真去打工啊，赚了很多钱。
This is no different from a person that really put a lot of effort to try to work and to make money.
带了一堆钱要回来给家人分享。
stored up his money and brought a home to enjoy with his family members.
在半路遇到强匪，把枪拿走，钱抢走，一脚把他踢出去。
Midway on his path to home, he was robbed, and the robber took all his money and kicked him to the side of the road.
那过去这么辛苦是做什么？
So to him at that moment, what's the meaning of that person's effort?
因为回到家里面空空啊，那过去你努力这么努力是做什么？
That person is going to go to his house empty-handed, and all the effort are all in vain.
所以死亡就是那个土匪。
So death is that robber.
我们一生努力的成果全部要被拿走。
That robber will rob us of everything, all of our accomplishments, all of our wealth and stores.
所以所罗门觉得很虚空。
That's why King Solomon concluded that life is
all in vain. 但是如果有一个人他回头看，他发现他生活的方向不一样。
However, if a person standing at the end of his life, looking back and seeing that his life is different from others.
当他往前看的时候，他就会看到不一样的景况。
And therefore, as a result, when he looks forward, he will also see a different scenery.
这个就是信仰的价值。
And that is there lies within the value of our faith.
所以信仰不要一直把它定义就是求好的工作让我们活得很平安。
Let us not set the standards of our faith to accomplish worldly gains and comforts in lives.
这个是初步刚刚入门的时候。
Those are very immature and elementary principles as you start believing in Christ.
如果我们信主几十年，整个头脑就是信耶稣让我有平安，工作顺利。
If after tens of years of faith in the Lord, and yet your conclusion and your goal of believing in the Lord is to gain comfort in this world, to have good jobs.
没有抓到信仰的重点。
Then you have not grasped and acquired the principle and the basics of our faith.
今生几十年是为着来世永永远远在准备，这个是信仰的概念。
The right concept and target of our faiths is that we strive and toil for years so we can gain in the life to come.
所以圣经说我们顾念不是看得见的。
So that's why the Bible reminds us that we should focus on things that we cannot see.
看得见是什么？这个世界。
What are the things we can see? That is the things in this world.
我们顾念是看不见的。
We should care about things that we can't see.
看不见的是什么？是灵界的。
Things we can't see are in the spiritual realm.
因为看得见的是暂时的，看不见是永远的。
Because the things we can see are temporary, the things we cannot see are eternal.
所以能够把我们带从物质界进到灵界，这个就是我们的信仰。
So our faith should be able to allow us to transform from our materialistic world into a spiritual realm.
从今生带到天国的福气，这个就是我们的信仰。
Our faith should be able to lead us from our lives on this world to the heavenly kingdom beyond.
好，那我们再看保罗是怎么活着。
So let us examine how did Paul live.
我们看腓立比书的第一章。
Let's turn back to Philippians chapter 1.
腓立比书的第一章。
Philippians chapter 1.
二十一节。
Verse 21.
腓立比书第一章二十一节。
Philippians chapter 1 verse 21. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain.
这里保罗说我活着就是基督，我死了就有益处。
Paul says here, to live is Christ, to die is gain.
如果我们站在生命的最后一点，
If we're looking at staring down at the last day of our life,
我回头过来看，我一生活着就是基督。
If we turn back, and all we see that our entire life is Christ.
那我往前看，我就看到死亡对我是有益处的。
Then if that's the case, when we look forward, then the death would be beneficial to us.
所以我们的信仰需要越来越成长。
So we need to mature and grow in our faiths.
我为什么活着？
We need to think about why are we living.
如果一个人不信神，
If a person does not believe in God,
我活着就是要表现我自己。
Then to live may mean to demonstrate one's ability or capabilities.
要把我这个人的极限活出来。
Then a person might want to live to the limits of his or her lives.
所以让人能够看得出来我是很有成就的人。
That's the goal of many, which is to demonstrate to others that you are filled with accomplishments.
因此我能够比别人更好，更突出，更出名。
To stand out amongst others, to be famous.
所以有很多人他一生有一个理想。
So many people have this one ideal in life.
他把那个理想当作是一种宗教在追求。
They treat their ideal as if that was their religion.
所以他的宗教是什么？他的宗教就是他头脑里面的理想。
And therefore, to these people, their religion is their philosophy in life or their ideal in life.
那一个虔诚的拜人拜神的人有多投入，他在追求他的理想有多投入，这个就是他的信仰。
And how much effort that you put into chasing this ideal is how much that you're going to put into chasing your religion.
所以这个是很多人一生活的目标。
So this is a very common strive and focus of many people.
活着就是要自我实现。
To live is to fulfill one's desire.
但是如果这样的话，我们面对人生最后一点，你就什么都没有看到，一片黑暗而已。
If that was the case, if you're standing upon the last day of your life, looking back, then you will see everything in a haze.
如果我们自己肯定自己，那我死了谁要肯定我？
Because if we're living throughout our lives to validate ourselves, then who's going to validate me when I die?
如果我做的是要别人肯定我，那这些人都会死啊，那谁要肯定我？
If my goal in this life is to have people endorse me, those people will die one day as well. Then who is going to endorse me?
所以生命是很可贵的。
So we need to understand that our lives are very precious.
但是当一个人没有认识神的知识，
However, if a person truly does not understand or have the knowledge of God,
他真的是不晓得为什么活着。
Then this person will never understand why he or she is living.
但是当我们活着是被神肯定，
However, if our goal of living is to be endorsed by God,
我们的生活在神看起来是有重量的，
Then our lives will have meaning and have weight.
那我们死了面对神，
Then at one day when we die, we will face upon God.
就大有益处。
Then it will be truly beneficial to us.
所以在这里说，我活着就基督，我死了就有益处。
So that's why Paul says here, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain.
所以这里让我们看到人生的一个新的方向。
This gives us a new direction in our lives.
工作需要吗？当然需要。
Do we need our jobs? Yes, we do.
养家需要吗？当然需要。
Do we need to look after our families? Of course.
六日要劳碌做工，这是没有改变的。
We don't need to change anything for the sixth day out of the week that we need to labor to make a living.
但是我们的工作，我们的生活，我们的家庭要达到一个更高的目标。
But for our family, for ourselves, our families to achieve a higher level of meaning in lives.
就是我活着就是基督。
Which is to live for the sacred Christ.
那到底这个是什么意思？
Then what does that mean?
好，我们回来看腓立比书第一章。
Turn back to Philippians chapter 1.
腓立比书第一章的二十节。
Philippians chapter 1 verse 20. Verse 20. According to my earnest expectation and hope that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but with all boldness, as always, so now as Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death.
这个地方啊，圣经说无论是生是死，要叫基督在我身上照常显大。
Here it tells us that whether by life or by death, Christ will be magnified in my body.
所以我活着就是基督，就是在我们生活中要把主耶稣显扬出来。
So for us, the meaning to live as Christ means that while we're living, we must magnify Christ through our daily lives.
有时候我们遇到一个人几十年了，我就是这样啊，我就是没有办法改变啊。
Sometimes we may encounter somebody saying, well, that's just the way I am. After my entire life, I can't change.
如果他没有信耶稣，这是实在的。
If that person does not believe in Christ, then that may be a fact.
人怎么有可能改变自己?
How can a person change his or herself by himself, by their own will?
但是如果一个人信主几十年，还就是说我就是这样啊，我没有办法改变啊。
But on the other hand, if a person in Christ, after believing in God for many years, still is saying that this is the way I am, how am I going to change?
低估了神的能力。
Then that person has belittled the power of influence of God.
神可以改变我们。
God can change all of us.
那神改变我们的目标是什么?
But why would God want to change us?
神要改变我们，让我们能够把基督的生命在我们生活中显现出来。
The reason why God wants to change us and influence us is so that we can magnify Christ through our bodies.
这个就是我们努力的目标。
That shall be the goal of our striving.
所以我们的信仰生活不是求神让我多赚一点钱，多享受一点，这个不是重点啊。
So we cannot be focusing in our faiths to ask God for more comforts in this life, to be more wealthier in our lives.
信仰的重点是什么？
What is the target and focus of our faiths?
神啊，我真的很难改变我自己。
It should be pleading to God, to acknowledge to God that the Lord, it's very difficult to change myself.
求你在我身上做工。
Please influence and preside over me.
让你的生命能够在我生活中彰显出来。
So that your life and your will can be magnified through my body.
如果我们生活的目标有这样的改变，
If we're able to embrace this type of change in our lives,
你就发现哦，年纪很大，还是很多要努力的地方。
Then you will realize that even though you're very advanced in age, that you will have a long list of things to improve on.
我们也发现了，每一天生活得很有意义。
And on the other hand, you will also find that you will live very meaningful lives every single day. Why?
因为每一个改变都是神在我身上做工。
Because every single change, every bit of improvements are the doings of God.
那每一个改变都是荣耀神的地方。
Every single change and improvements will be an opportunity for us to glorify God.
因为我们越来越能显扬基督的本性。
Because more and more we'll have the ability to magnify Christ through our bodies.
每一天的生活。我们因为得到神的喜悦，我们也觉得很喜乐，因为我真的在进步。
And in turn, that we will receive joy through our daily lives because we will experience God.
所以我们要让基督在我们身上显大。
So, again, we need to allow Christ to magnify our bodies.
我们看哥林多后书第二章。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians.
哥林多后书的第二章
2 Corinthians chapter 2
14节
Verse 14 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 14 Now thanks be to God who always leads us in triumph in Christ and through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place
这里讲啊，感谢神率领我们在基督里夸胜。
It tells us that thanks to be God who always leads us in triumph in Christ.
这个夸胜是什么?
What does it mean to be triumph?
这个夸胜是在灵里面的得胜。
This means to prevail in spirit.
就是不断的突破那个旧的我、罪的我，那让基督的生命一直成长出来。
It means that we constantly break through our old selves to create our new selves in our spirit.
那下面说，并借着我们在各处显扬那因认识基督而有的香气。
And in the second part of this verse says, through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place.
我们知道主耶稣吸引很多人。
We know that Jesus Christ in this world attracted a lot of people.
我们今天到这里来不是被勉强的。
The fact that you are sitting here today was not by force.
我们是被吸引的。
We are attracted.
因为基督的身上有香气。
Attracted by the fragrance of Jesus Christ.
那这个地方就是要让基督的香气在我们身上显扬出来。
So here, this verse says that through us, the fragrance of Jesus Christ will be diffused through every place.
啊，圣经里面在啊腓立比书里面提到啊主耶稣的香气。
In Book of Philippians, it also talks about the fragrance of Lord Jesus Christ.
我们看腓立比书第二章。
Let's look at Philippians chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2.
第五节。
Verse 5. Verse 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus.
第六节。
Verse 6. Who, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God.
第七节。
Verse 7.But made himself of no reputation, taking in form of a bondservant, and coming in the likeness of men.
第八节。
Verse 8. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of cross.
这个地方讲基督的心。
Here describes Jesus' heart.
如果我们能够把基督的心活出来，基督的香气就在我们身上。
If we're able to live out the heart of Christ, then we will be giving out the fragrance to others.
这里讲基督的心提到两个重点。
And here talks about two main points.
第一个就是虚己。
We have to be humble.
他本来是神。
He was, Jesus used, was God.
但是他来世界上要救人。
But he came to this world to save men.
他不把自己当作神。
He did not equate himself to the equal with God.
所以神降为人，人降为仆人。
That's why he came transformed from the form of God to man and to really transform to be servants of others.
所以他才可以洗人的脚，可以服侍人啊。
That's why he was able to wash others' feet.
这个
why he was able to serve others.
这个就是基督的香气。
That was the fragrance of Lord Jesus Christ.
你看我们是人。
We are all human beings.
每一个人要膨胀自己，被人看起来当神。
And yet, every one of us wants to boast ourselves, like as we want to proclaim or something in front of God.
要用很多外在来包装自己，提升自己的价值，好像神一样。
We package ourselves, we elevate ourselves with outer appearance as if we are equal with God.
但是基督的香气不是这样。
But the Jesus Christ's fragrance is not there.
不管我是谁。
No matter who we are.
我在世界上有什么。
No matter what we possess in this world.
我愿意虚己来服侍人。
Are we able to humble ourselves to serve others?
这个就是香气。
That is the fragrance of Lord Jesus Christ.
这个不简单啊。
That's not something that's very easily carried out.
好，那第二个。
Second point.
第八节。
Verse 8.
就是舍己。
He sacrificed himself.
所以他可以顺服。
So therefore he was able to be obedient.
现在的人自主性很强。
These days people are very self-righteous.
不愿意听别人讲你应该做什么。
They don't like to hear others guiding them or telling them what they should do.
但是当一个人来到神的面前。
However, when a person comes before Christ,
人愿意把自主性拿掉。
If we're able to lift away our self-centeredness,
神啊，我愿意顺服你。
If we're able to plead to God that, Lord, we are willing to obey you.
你要我做什么，我都愿意做。
Whatever your will commands, I shall carry out.
你要我去哪里，我都愿意去。
Wherever you want me to go, I shall go.
这个是一种基督的香气。
That is a type of fragrance of Lord Jesus Christ.
所以主耶稣到生命的最后一口气。
That is why when Jesus was at the last, taking his last breath in this world,
面向耶路撒冷。
He was facing Jerusalem.
做什么？被钉十字架。
He was being crucified on the cross.
他勇敢往前去。
Yet he carried forth bravely.
把神对人最大的爱表现出来。
He carried out and manifested the ultimate love of God to men.
所以我们对生死的看法是什么？
So let's evaluate our perspective on life or death.
我活着就是基督。
that we should acknowledge that to live is Christ.
这是我们努力的目标。
That should be our target and our strive.
我死的就有益处。
We should also acknowledge to die is to gain.
我们的人生就非常的充实。
If we feel this way, then we will live a very fulfilling life.
唱诗。
Please sing hymn.
193
Sing hymn 193.